going to my presentation of the paper. The contribution of Kerala to astronomy and mathematics has now been discussed in is already been discussed in detail by the eminent scholar K.V. Sharma in his famous book, A History of the Kerala School of Hindu Astronomy in 1972. Just trying to say some technicalities. I don't know if it is correct. I am just for I just put forth my doubts while reading the text Bhadradeepam. It's a vernacular astronomical text belong to 17th century AD. I just put forth some of my doubts to all the scholars gathered. Among the astronomical works from Kerala, we can see the influence of Aryabhatiya and Lilavati in several vernacular mathematical and astronomical works. Apart from that, it is worth to be noted that most of the texts in Kerala astronomical tradition follow the Aryabhata system or grid system. Generally, it is said like that. Most of them follow the Aryabhata system or grid system. It is based on the following two facts. The first one is that the commentaries on Aryabhatiya the availability of several commentaries in Sanskrit and Malayalam in the major repositories of Kerala, in Calicut, Tribhuvanithura, and Trivandrum, we can see several Sanskrit and Malayalam commentaries on Aryabhatiya. The second aspect is that wide acceptance of grid system after the introduction of the grid system by Vadashiri Parameshwar. These are the two aspects which support the first fact, that is, Kerala School of Astronomy and Mathematics depends mostly on Aryabhata system and grid system. Here in my paper, I just put forth the following three suggestions or like that. I just put for three suggestions. I don't know if it is correct. Next page. Do the later vernacular astronomical texts from Kerala use the theories or concepts in Surya Siddhanta? Generally, we say that we follow the Kerala school follow the Aryabhata system or grid system, but while reading the text Bhadradeepam, Yukti Bhasha, and Rikaranam, I just feel that it uses the theories, the Kerala school use the theories or concepts in Surya Siddhanta. The second point is how these texts illustrate and develop the theories based on Surya Siddhanta to support or otherwise reject the grid system. I don't know if it is used to reject the grid system or support the grid system, but I can see some elements from the Surya Siddhanta. Third point, how the text Bhadradeepa of Edakkamanchiri Nambuthiri, it belongs to the 17th century. The date is given by K.V. Sharma. It is book, A History of the Kerala School of Hindu Astronomy. It explains Palangula experiment, the experiment to find the equinoctial shadow. The English term for Palabha or Palangula. And does the Surya Siddhanta influence the vernacular astronomical tradition of Kerala? These are my suggestions like that. I just try to answer these questions in my paper. I don't know if it is correct. I think that you all know the Surya Siddhanta is a very earlier text which belongs to 5th century BC, and later it was the theory saying Surya Siddhanta was compiled by Varahamihira in his some of the theories were compiled by Varahamihira in his Panja Siddhantika. In Surya Siddhanta also we can see the same description of equinoctial shadow. In that text it says Palabha. Surya Siddhanta uses the term Palabha. Interestingly, while I am reading the text Yukti Bhasha of Jyeshta Deva, Drikkarana, K.V. Sharma also says that Drikkarana is also the text of Jyeshta Deva, but he has some doubts on that. So I just put a question mark after the Jyeshta or the after the next. I have put a question mark here, but it is considered that Drikkarana is also the text of Jyeshta Deva. And reading the text Bhagavad-gita also, I can see the same similar verses and similar text, textual verses in all these vernacular astronomical texts. Next slide. Now I am going to, I am just concentrating on the text Bhadradipa. Bhadradipa is an unpublished Kerala astronomical text with mathematical computations. It comprises of 11 chapters. It is written in verses and also it is in Manipravala style. Manipravala is a form of, it's a mixture of Sanskrit and Malayalam. The text begins with the following invocative verses. Vikmisham Kavimadiniya Udane Krishnam Guru Vyasani Sri Suryadi Navagrahan Udumanan Lakshmi Puradhishwaram Vandichittuda Indira Patimacham Vishnum Puranam Param Vandeham Pedomannakya Bhavani Vaadunna Narayanam. Having paid obeisance to Vikmisha Saraswati, then Krishna, the sage Vyasa, the nine planets begin with the sun, stars. Immediately I salute Narayana, who resides in the place Perumalpura, the deity of Lakshmipura, the husband of Indira, Lakshmi, the one who is beyond the world, the one who is pervading all Purana and novel. Next slide. This is the Perumalpura Mahavishnu temple in Calicut. The place Perumalpura is near to Calicut, and I just get an opportunity to go to that place because last few months ago I have to work on this place because of the Rosar in Zuri. So I have to make more information. I'm just interested in that place and going to collect details regarding the authorship. It is interesting that K.V. Sharma noted the author as Idapramanjeri Nambudiri. Only denotes that the author is Idapramanjeri Nambudiri. I just go to the place Perumalpura and I have got some interesting details on the authorship. Just present that. And in the second verse, Vishnu Jangama Malayam Bhumi Janayam Place the shampoo. Shampoo is the gnome role which is a cylindrical robot, in the center of the circle, having the diameter of one pole of measurement. Mark two points on the circle, here A and B are those points. Above, the shadow of the row touches the circle in the midday, during the midday. Then we get the form of a fish, as in figure 2. As in figure 2, we get the shape of a fish. They say that this looks like a fish, like that. I don't know. Looks like a fish. They say that it looks like a fish. From this, we can also draw the north-south line, as in the figure 2. If we fix the ground in the middle of the south-north line in the afternoon, we get a shadow in the north of that line in precise. We get the sushma value. Measure it in angula and convert it into angula. But I don't know the how we can convert angula measure to angula. I don't know how can it be done. But it's say like that. First of all, we have to measure it in angula and then convert it into angula. We have to understand that this would be the we done this experiment, we get the palangula of that place and that at any time. And in Bhadradeva, he gives the author Edamanchini Namudri gives the palangula value of the major places in Kerala. Next slide. It is the birth in Surya Siddhanta. Shilandale ambusanchute vajralepi vasami tatra shankulangule ishtai sam mandala malike tanmadhye stavayet shankum kalpana vada shankula tachaya gram smishet yatra vritte uva parabhidau tatra bindu vidhayo bho vritte uva parabhidau tanmadhye timina rekha kartavya dakshina uttara. Here the word timi. The word thini is used for denoting the fish. Thini is used for denoting the fish. And in the next slide, I have given the translation of Burgess, E. Burgess to the Surya Siddhanta. It is the translation of the above words. On a stony surface, may water level or upon hard plaster, made level, the draw an even circle of a radius equal to any required number of the digits, angula of the gnomon. At its center, set up the gnomon of 12 digits of the measure fixed upon, and the extremity of its shadow touches the circle in the former and after parts of the day. It's like that. It's a translation of Burgess. I just conclude my paper. Conclusion. The mathematical test or with astronomical computations like Bhadradeva will definitely lead us to reconstruct the vernacular tradition of vernacular or regional tradition of Kerala. So we have to give serious attention on that part, especially on editing and translating and start analyzing these aspects in astronomical and mathematical tradition of Kerala. Thank you.
Thank you now for the discussion. So we can take, I think, 5 minutes because we have to finish two more papers in this session and
how they actually find the parabola and tell you later. That's a different thing. Two other comments which I think we should understand. One, this method is not Surya Siddhanta. The earliest recorded text is Vedavini Upanishad. Okay, number one. Number two, if you don't want to look at the recorded text but look at the practices, okay, material practices where you have some evidence. I mean, if you look at astronomy, then you can ascribe this method to tribals of India. Method to tribals of India. Okay. So, if you go to some places, you will find a stone which is kept erect. Okay. And then there will be two small stones. I mean, this will be like a pillar. Then there will be two small stones. So, actually, exactly at the local protocol, not our Indian standard type protocol, exactly at local protocol, the shadow will be somewhere here. On the day when it is Uttarayan, the shadow will be on the northernmost stone. On the day of Dakshinayan, the moon shadow will be on the southernmost stone. So, any other day will be somewhere in between. So, it's the same method of finding cardinal directions plus time of the day, year, various things you get from this. I mean, I won't get into that. So, this method is nothing to do with the Surya Siddhartha. This method is a very well known method which is used in wide variety of areas.
Sir, then I think that it's belong to the regional tradition of Pan Indian tradition of.
Actually, this method is all over the world.
Okay.
Actually, stone is the entire
So I think that if for finding of the computing the time of so how we are finding out the angle of that place to find out the latitude of that place.
Yeah, I mean, if you have to explain, then I have to do a bit of positional astronomy. I don't want to take up the time. You say only 5 minutes, most because I will explain.
Thank you very much. Very interesting. I share your feeling that there's some Siddhanta influence in this text, although I also cannot commit to it. Not specifically because of this, because we, as we were told, this is not something special for Surya Siddhanta. But in order to check this, we need to find the places where Rigarika and Surya Siddhanta do not agree and see if in any of these places you find in the Vanadipa an acceptance or at least a consideration of the Surya Siddhanta movement. So this would be a good test. Also, if you manage to convince that this is influenced by the Surya Siddhanta, then this translates into a historical social question. Why does the tradition which initially prefers Arabatiya and Rigarika suddenly in the 17th century goes back to the Surya Siddhanta? What kind of social changes, intellectual changes lead to this use of older knowledge which was out of fashion?
In the Bhagavad Gita, it is interesting that, first of all, I want to state that I'm already working in the mathematical field of Kerala. I'm just interestingly, I just happen to work on this work. I don't know more about the astronomical part of Kerala. In the text Bhagavad Gita, the third chapter begins with to find the grip part. How can we find out the drip path? It's like that. Ini drigganita te parayum. Hereafter I say the drigganita path. It begins like that. And after that, the author describes the palangula experiment just similar to this type of. I don't know if it is. You say that it's not Surya Siddhanta. It's the regional tradition of India. I think that it's from Surya Siddhanta. I think that I have also the same doubt you have said how or why the Kerala astronomers take this experiment related to the regional tradition or Surya Siddhanta tradition to develop or develop or substantiate their arguments regarding the Rigveda Rig system. The text begins like that. In Rigveda Rig, hereafter I say the Rigveda. In that chapter, we can see this experiment. But I don't know how he explained this experiment. The similar experiment we can see in Yukti Bhasha and Dhrukarana. Let's go.
Quick comment. Number one, when you were talking about the different, when you were talking about Surya Siddhanta or Aryabhatiya, etc., number one, they don't majorly differ in terms of instrument use, concepts use, or some of the methodologies of finding, let's say, the position of sun, shadow line, etc., etc. There is no variation. The variation is only on two counts, broadly. One can draw many things, but broadly variations are, so that way they are not called as different theories, they are called as different schools. Okay, the variation is based on only two. Number one is constants. What is the length of 1 year? Or what is the number of revolution a particular heavenly body will make in one Mahayuga? Okay, so this kind of constants vary across schools, number one. Dhrukarana largely, all the Kerala school Dhrukarana largely, as far as I know, follow only Aryabhatiya in school, meaning that they take those numbers as sacred, number one. Number two question is, which is paramount? Is the older text, that is Agama Pramana, is it paramount? Or Dhrid, or Pratyaksha Pramana, which is paramount? Okay? Within these two, when there is a conflict, which should remain supreme? There is a debate. Okay, so the schools vary only on these two.
That is the importance of this kind of calculation. hope we have to do a lot of work in these texts in order to bring out the correct meanings of all these information, and the use of the information contained in these texts also. Thank you very much, Sunita, for this excellent paper. Next, I invite Srijit for presenting his paper on mathematical education in pre-colonial Kerala, historical roots.
Respected Chair and fellow delegates, at the outset, let me tell you that I am very weak, for my knowledge in mathematics is very limited. What I am doing in this paper is to analyze certain features of pedagogic aspects of the Kerala mathematics education in Kerala. Meanwhile, I also offer to explain the historical background against which the mathematics became a popular subject in Kerala. And many aspects of the Kerala mathematics is already explained by Ranjan Narayanan and etc. are already